if you have the coordinate vector x be in Rn, you do not need the vector x to compute the coordinate vector xc in Rn. You can do this directly. But such a conversion is a composition of two coordinate mappings, so a composition of two linear mappings, which means that this composition is a linear mapping itself and thus implemented by some matrix. But how can we find this matrix that allows us to convert coordinate vectors? That is what you will learn in this video. So what's the setting? We have some general vector space above here and some vector x in that. Then we have two bases, b consisting of u1 up till un and c consisting of v1 up till vn. And that means that our vector x has two coordinate vectors, and xb, vector in Rn, the coordinate with respect to the vector, with respect to the basis b, and the coordinate vector xc, also a normal vector in Rn, but now containing the weight with respect to the basis c. Now, question, how can we convert those coordinate vectors into each other without going back to x? Because x can be some nasty vector in some nasty vector space. We rather not do that. We rather convert them directly. So, what's the trick? Want to determine some matrix P from B to C. That is the trick. So, that converts XP via the matrix P from B to C into an XC. So, how can we find this matrix? Notice it's just some normal matrix because these two over here are normal vectors in Rn. So first we start with xb, and we write it as c1 up till cn, as the weights. We do not know the weights, but that doesn't matter. Xb is some vector in Rn. Then we know, in principle, what our x is. X equals c1 u1 up till cn un, because the xb contains the weight with respect to the basis b. And now we compute our xc. Our x with respect to c, well, we know what x is, that's over here. So this whole expression in the basis C. But now we can use that the coordinate mapping is a linear mapping. So C1 U1 plus C2 U2, etc. in the basis C equals C1 times U1 in the basis C, etc. So we get X in the basis C equals C1 times U1 in the basis C up till Cn times Un in the basis C. But now we're happy again, because what do we have over here? X in the basis C, which is a vector in Rn, equals a scalar times u1 in the basis c. But u1, that's a nasty vector, but u1 in the basis c is the coordinate vector with respect to c, so that's again a normal vector in Rn. So we have c1 times a normal vector plus c2 times a normal vector up till cn times a normal vector. So what we have over here is again a product scalar times vector plus scalar times vector, etc. So we can rewrite that as a product of a matrix times a vector, where in the matrix we put our vectors u1 in c up till un in c, and in the vector we put our weight c1 up till cn. But this vector here on the right is just our vector xb. And over here we have xc, and over here we have some matrix, but that is exactly the desired matrix. That is our change of coordinates matrix P from B to C. So how do you find your P from B to C? You take all your vectors in your original basis P, U1, U2, etc., and then you compute its coordinate vector in the new basis C, and you put those in the matrix. So you have U1 in the basis C, U2 in the basis C, etc., up till Un in the basis C. So to summarize, that's the P from B to C. And similarly, if you want to go the other way around, you can either compute the inverse, of course, to get the P from C to B, or just use the other formula. Just replace this, the basis B and C. So instead of U in the basis C, you get V in the basis B, if you want to compute your P from C to B. Now, finally, what's an easy way to remember this formula, to memorize the formula? Well, if you replace the C over here by an E, by the standard by a standard basis, then you get P from B to E, which is just PB, the normal matrix PB. So if you have a PB, then over here you should get a PB as well. Well, if you replace the C by an E, you get U1 in E, which is just U1. So if you replace your C by an E, on the left-hand side you get your PB, and on the right-hand side you get the matrix that you want up till the end, which is indeed your PB. So if you want to check whether your formula is correct, always just replace the C by an E. Then you see whether you indeed get the correct formula for your PB, and then continue with the general one, P from B to C.